Hello and welcome to our session on undergraduate education in psychology. My name is Jacqueline Ronchio-Adachi and I'm psychology faculty at Cerritos College and also serving as co-chair for APA's Committee on Associate and Baccalaureate Education. Today I am joined by my colleagues, Karen Brocky from Spelman College, Diane Finley from Prince George's Community College, Todd Joseph from Hillsborough Community College, and Karen Knoffel from Georgia Southern University. I am sure many of you who are viewing this talk are doing so with the intention of gaining professional development, but ultimately because you would like to best serve your students. This is what we aim to do on CABE. That is to serve our students in the best possible way, as well as psychology faculty. Our mission includes representing psychology faculty and students at undergraduate institutions, promoting within all undergraduate institutions the highest professional standards for teaching of psychology as a scientific discipline with applications to a wide range of human concerns. We also would like to develop leadership qualities among undergraduate psychology faculty and students and increase their participation and representation in psychology organizations. We'd also aim to establish and maintain communication with all groups that are involved in the teaching of psychology and to encourage scholarship on teaching and learning at all undergraduate institutions. Overall, we like to promote within all institutions the highest standards in the teaching of psychology for undergraduate students. One of the ways in which this mission is realized is through the collaborative efforts of psychology faculty and scholars that have come together to create many products housed on the APA Undergraduate Education website and the APA Associate and Baccalaureate Educators website. Our aim for today's talk is to help you navigate the website and find all of these wonderful resources for you and your students. So what I'll do now is I will go ahead and I will navigate over to the website. This is the URL for the website, apa.org/ed/pre-college/undergrad. As you can see, there are a variety of resources here dedicated to undergraduate psychology. For example, one of those products is preparing to use your bachelor's degree in psychology. The task force that created this product was interested in highlighting the skills that psychology majors develop that can be used in the job hunt for a job in psychology. I'm now going to pass it over to Karen Knoffel, who will be talking about the skillful psychology student, as well as APA's introductory psychology initiative. Karen?
Hi. So the skillful psychology student is another product that CABE developed. It came out of the skillful psychology working group under CABE. What this working group did is they looked at skills that employers wanted, and they also mapped them on to the skills that psychology majors or psychology coursework can provide. And so these skills can be, students can acquire these skills both at the associate and baccalaureate level. So this poster right here is just one resource that shows all of the skills that psychology can provide that employers want and that are phrased in ways that employers look for. Additionally, we also have a couple of articles out in the Psychology Teacher Network about the skillful psychology student that can provide information on how to use this resource and how to cultivate these skills throughout an undergraduate program, both at the associate and baccalaureate level. Now, we're talking a lot about psychology majors right now or study in the associate and baccalaureate level, but one thing that's also important to know is that it all starts somewhere. And that somewhere is the APA introductory psychology course. The introductory psychology course is a course that literally a million students take each year. And so we have formed the APA introductory psychology initiative. And this is an initiative under CABE that looks at the best practices in teaching introductory psychology. So for instance, some of the things that this initiative has looked at is the student learning outcomes and assessments associated with introductory psychology. It also has looked at course models and designs. There's also workshops for teacher training and development. And finally, there's also a section for student success and transformation, essentially what skills beyond just content knowledge do students develop in this course that they can take with them as they pursue a psychology major or another major. And so the Introductory Psychology Initiative is another initiative that provides tons of resources, including activities, assessments, learning outcomes, best practices in teaching introductory psychology that you can use.
All right, so I'm going to talk next about one of the, I think, most widely used resources that APA's Education Directorate provides, the APA Guidelines for the Undergraduate Psychology Major. I imagine many of you are familiar with these. If you're not, you really need to be. They are so useful on many different levels. Right now, we are operating under version 2.0, version 3.0 with even further refinements is on its way. Keep your eyes open for that. But right now we have five learning goals and outcomes that are skills-based. So they're very adaptable to different curricula, to both associate and baccalaureate education. In fact, there are foundational and advanced goals objectives throughout. So you can look at foundational skills and then baccalaureate level skills. And of course, these five areas currently are knowledge base, scientific inquiry and critical thinking, ethical and social responsibility in a diverse world, communication and professional development. And if you've been following the conversations in our discipline at all, these are all very highly valued right now, and people are looking for ways to measure these and to include these in the curriculum. So this guide is very, very helpful for individual courses and assignments, as well as for programmatic concerns for departments and programs in deciding what your curriculum includes and what to assess. Which of course leads into, for many of us, accreditation requirements. So at many levels, these are helpful. And the guidelines are linked to one of CABE's first initiatives when it became an official committee, which was the Summit for National Assessment of Psychology, which has yielded a wonderful resource called the Project Assessment, or PASS for short. And this takes those five goals that I mentioned, and a group of teachers got together and developed assessments and contributed assignments with assessments in each of those areas. So once you go in, you do have to register. It's free, of course. Once you log in and register, then you can access this wonderful set of assignments and assessments that are linked to each outcome. And you can download them, you can contribute yourself if you've got one that you think would be fantastic for this resource, you may contribute it yourself. And it's wonderful just to go through and look at all these ideas that people have contributed. Particularly these days when many of us are looking for innovative ways to assess our students and providing engaging assignments. So I'm going to pass it along to Diane Finley now.
Thanks, Karen. One of the other areas that CABE has done some work on is in the area of adjunct faculty, because we recognize what a large percentage of our faculty these days, both at the associate and baccalaureate area, are adjuncts. So a few years ago, one of the projects that came out of CABE's predecessor was the Adjunct Faculty Resource Guide. And I actually think that it's helpful for all faculty, not just adjuncts, although in there it addresses some issues about how to find a job in psychology. It goes through three areas: getting started, with some basics about how do you get hired, how do you grade, some just basics of class organization and content. Part two focuses really on class management and creating a syllabus. And then the third part is on getting connected with the discipline, with professional organizations, and how that can help you, and how that can help you serve as an advocate for your students. I've actually used this with new faculty at my college because it succinctly summarizes some of what we want them to know, and it's free and easy to find, and those resources are not always there. I also like it because then you know that when it's talking about how to create a syllabus, how to do this grading, how to deal with class attendance, you're not the only person dealing with it. And so I think both for adjuncts and for full-time faculty, it can be a helpful resource. And the other document that was created by CABE's predecessor was the Institutional Review Board, a college planning guide. This really came out of a need at two-year colleges for creation of an IRB, since we know that if research by students doesn't go through the IRB, generally they can't present it or try to publish it. And as doing their own research becomes even more important for two-year students, a lot of two-year faculty were saying, we need some documentation to take to our administration so that we can create an IRB. And in this resource, it gives information on how to get started. It covers federal regulations, a lot of sample forms from various places, recognizing that, as always, the Office of Human Research is really the primary driver of IRB policies and so forth. But it's a nice little document that you can give to someone who may not be familiar with what an IRB is and how to get it started. And again, it's freely available on the APA website, and we hope that you'll be able to use it. And now Todd Joseph is going to talk about a couple of other things, and I'll pass it along to Todd.
Hi, everyone. All of you are aware that there's been a big push lately for evidence-based teaching techniques. CABE has had a big play in this area, and one of the most important products that we've created is a new APA guide on college teaching, essential tools and techniques based on psychological science. This ebook describes 21 different concepts from the field of psychology that are highly important for college teaching and learning. The concepts are broken down into five different categories, different areas within a course that you might find important. These include how our students think and learn, motivating our students, the importance of social context, interpersonal relationships, and emotional and physical well-being, managing our classrooms, and assessing students' progress. So these five different categories each have several different concepts that apply. Each of the principles within this document is explained well with plenty of context, and it includes scientific references. So if you want to read more, if you want to demonstrate what evidence there is for your techniques, you can use this. So this is a great tool for psychology classes, but more importantly, this is important for all courses in higher education. And so we highly suggest that you can share this with your colleagues. One of the things that sharing this will do, it will increase the importance and understanding of the field of psychology across your college and across other disciplines, which I think is very important. It looks like we're at the end of our presentation. There are a lot of other resources available on the CABE website. So go there, take some time, look through. If you want to stay connected with CABE, and we hope that you do, and that you'd be updated on our upcoming and our ongoing projects, please join the CABE listserv and regularly visit APA's Psychology Teacher Network page. And don't forget to nominate yourself or a colleague for a CABE Teaching Resource Award. Thank you again, and enjoy teaching.